And Jim, this is going to be a very highly competitive race, as I'm joined by Ronaldo Nehemiah. You can see the shadow line as the sun begins to go down back to the western rim of the Coliseum, which is again full tonight, and we had an estimated crowd. They told us 88,000 was the estimate this morning, and they cleared everybody out, and a lot of those folks and some others came back in, and we're full again tonight. Women's 100-meter hurdles, a very, very highly competitive race. Benita Fitzgerald-Brown will certainly be one lady to watch in lane four. Won the gold at the Pan American Games, her all-time best 12.84. Do you think she's going to win it, Skeets?
I think she has a great shot. She came into this final now with the fastest qualifying time. Shirley Strong ran an impressive 12.86 in her semi, but she slacked off. But it should be competitive, as you said, because we have six women, 13.2 or better.
So you got Benita Fitzgerald-Brown in four, and that race is going to be in 4, 5, 6, and 7 for the most part. You got Michele Chardonnet, as you say, in 5, Kim Turner, U.S., and 6, Shirley Strong is in 7. And then you've got Pam Page of the United States in lane 2. Michele Chardonnet of France with an all-time best of 13.02. Kim Turner, 12.95. Again, this is the race which provided so much suspense and drama in the Olympic trials. As you look at the lane assignments, Glenys Nunn already owns a gold medal. She won the heptathlon. Pam Page of the United States, who just did edge Stephanie Hightower for third place in the trials. Ulrika Denk, the national record holder in West Germany. Then Benita Fitzgerald-Brown, to whom we have referred. Next to her is Michele Chardonnet of France. Her time in the semis, 13.09. Kim Turner won the Olympic trials, NCAA champ from Texas, El Paso, in lane 6. Shirley Strong, fifth in the World Championships last year in Helsinki, in lane 7, and on the outside will be Marie-Noëlle Savigny of France. Who do you think's the quickest starter?
I think Kim Turner will get out right away. Shirley Strong is a very good starter. They're both, you know, very short in height and low to the ground, so they tend to get out quick. It'll take Benita a little bit longer to get going, but I say second or third hurdle, she'll start making a move. Another added incentive for our American hurdlers is that the last time an American won a medal was in 1932 when the hurdles were first introduced to the game. So, you know, 52 years later, it'd be great to see an American get in the final three.
And it was Babe Didrikson who won the gold in 1932 with Evelyn Hall taking the silver medal. Only two have made the final since then. Again, as we mentioned before, it's an event that is severely impacted by the Eastern Bloc boycott. But here are the ladies involved in a race that figures to be maybe even as close as that one in the Olympic trials. Let's face it, three of the ladies who are involved in that race are in this one. Women's 100-meter hurdles. Page in 2, Fitzgerald-Brown in 4, Turner in 6.
Set.
And from the start, good start for Pam Page, also for Kim Turner, and also for Benita Fitzgerald-Brown. It's Benita Fitzgerald-Brown with Shirley Strong. Fitzgerald-Brown is strong. Fitzgerald-Brown is strong, and Benita wins it with Strong finishing in second place. And Kim Turner and Michele Chardonnet crossing in tandem for third. But Fitzgerald-Brown, side by side with Shirley Strong over the last four hurdles, and just does pull in front at the very end to win the gold medal in the women's 100-meter hurdle.
And as we said earlier, Al, it would take Benita a little bit longer to get started. You know, she comes on late in the race, but if the clock is official, that's great for her. 12.85, a PR being 12.84. Fantastic. What a way to run close to a personal record in the Olympic Games. We said Shirley Strong got out very quickly, as so did Kim Turner in lane number 6. Round lane 3, about the third hurdle, as I said, Benita Fitzgerald would come on very strongly. Right here, right now, she's running neck and neck with Shirley Strong. Shirley Strong may have even had her a little bit going over to the 6th or 7th hurdle, but Benita Fitzgerald knows that she's been here before leading about 7th, 8th hurdles. She knows that she gets stronger, she's faster. As I said, she has great leg speed for a tall woman.
It's a live insert of her watching exactly what you are watching right now on the big screen, and now she knows it. She knows she's won it.
Very close final right here, but Benita Fitzgerald, 6 foot tall almost. Great race.